मॉर्निंग चिल्ड्रन, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी मॉड्यूल 2 क्लास 9 साइंस चैप्टर 6 टिश्यूज. एज यू रिमेंबर इन द प्रीवियस मॉड्यूल वी हैव स्टडीड अबाउट द मेरिस्टमेटिक सेल्स, देयर टाइप्स एंड फंक्शंस. नाउ टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी अबाउट द परमानेंट टिश्यूज. Now before starting the permanent tissues, let us see few differences between the meristematic tissues and the permanent tissues. As you remember, in the meristematic tissues, the cells, they are actively dividing and they are continuously dividing. Whereas in the permanent tissues, they have lost the power of division. That's why they are not dividing continuously. These permanent tissues, they originate from the meristematic tissues only, and they are made up of mature cells which have undergone growth and differentiation. That's why the permanent cells, they possess a definite shape, size and function. So the cells of the meristematic tissues, they are small and isodiametric, whereas the permanent tissues, their cells vary in shape and size. In the meristematic tissues, generally the cell wall is thin, whereas in the case of permanent tissues, the cell wall is thick. As I have told you that the meristematic cells, they are continuously dividing. That's why their nuclei are large. And as the permanent tissues, they have lost the power of division. So the nuclei of the cells of permanent tissues, they are small. Now vacuoles are absent in the meristematic tissues, whereas the vacuoles, they are present in the permanent tissues. The intercellular spaces in between the cells of meristematic tissues, either they are very small or they are absent, whereas the intercellular spaces between the permanent tissues, they are present. The metabolic activities in case of meristematic tissues, the rate is very high, as they are continuously dividing, whereas in the case of permanent tissues, the metabolic rate is low. Inorganic inclusions are absent in the meristematic tissues, whereas they are present in the permanent tissues. The cells of the meristematic tissues, they are undifferentiated. That means they are not performing particular functions, whereas the cells are differentiated in case of the permanent tissues. That means they are assigned particular functions. Meristematic tissue is a simple tissue, whereas permanent tissue can be simple or complex. Now let us see the classification of permanent tissue. It is classified into two broad categories of simple permanent tissue and complex permanent tissue. The simple permanent tissue is further divided as parenchyma, colenchyma and sclerenchyma. Whereas complex permanent tissue, it is divided as xylem and phloem. Children, before starting the classification and detailed study of simple permanent tissue, let us understand few basic terms like what is a section cutting. To study a detailed structure of plants, we generally use the terms cross section or transverse section and longitudinal section. So in this figure you can observe that how a cross section is cut and how a longitudinal section is cut. That is, what is a cross section and what is a longitudinal section. And here, if we cut a section of a stem, of a plant stem, this is the cross section or transverse section, and this is the longitudinal section. Here you can see the different layers of the cells and tissues. Like the outermost layer is called as a epidermis. And here you can see that after that hypodermis is there, cortical region is there, then endodermis is present, after endodermis pericycle is there, then phloem, cambium, metaxylem, protoxylem, medullary rays. Basically, the xylem and phloem, they form a vascular bundle, and in the center of the stem, it is again packed with the cells, and this is called as a pith. Why I have shown you the section of the stem? Because in the further studies, we are going to study about that where which tissue is present. So, let us start with the classification and detailed study of the simple permanent tissues. As I have told you, they are of three types: parenchyma, collenchyma, and sclerenchyma. Now, starting with the parenchyma. Parenchyma cells, they are unspecialized and primitive. And this tissue, basically, it forms a basic packing tissue of the plant body in between the specialized tissues. And this tissue is present in large amount. The parenchyma word is taken from a Greek word in which para means beside and enchein means to pour. So, the cells of the parenchyma tissue, they are isodiametric. If we see cross section, we found that cells may be circular, oval, or they may be polygonal. And sometimes we have found elongated cells also. Generally, the cells of this tissue, they have thin walls which are made up of cellulose or calcium pectate. Mostly the intercellular spaces, as you can see here, the space between the two cell is called as intercellular space. They are present in case of parenchyma tissues. Now, they are living cells and they contain dense protoplasm. They have a prominent or a distinct nucleus and a large central vacuole. And as I have told you earlier, that these are the most abundant tissues found in plant. These tissues, they are mostly found in roots, stem, leaves, flowers and fruits. And they constitute a major vegetative ground tissue. They occur in epidermis, cortex, pith, pericycle and mesophyll of leaves. And also in the pulp of fruit, endosperm of seeds. And parenchymatous cells, they are also found in xylem and phloem. Now, let us see the types of parenchyma tissue. The first is storage parenchyma. Storage parenchymatous cells are large as they store the nutrients and water. So, the main function of this storage parenchyma is the storage of food like starch, fats, proteins, etc. Now, the other type of parenchyma tissue, that is chlorenchyma. Chlorenchyma is the parenchymatous cells of the chlorenchyma, they contain the chloroplast. You can see these dotted structures in these cells, they are the chloroplast. And as we know that chloroplast, they help in the process of photosynthesis. So, they are generally found in the mesophyll of the leaves because the photosynthetic activity, it takes place generally in the leaves. Now, the other type of parenchyma, it is arenchyma. That is, it is generally present in the aquatic plants, and this tissue is called as arenchyma as it has cavities or spaces which store gases and they provide buoyancy to the aquatic plants to help them to float. Here you can see these gaps. Okay, now the another specialized secretory parenchyma cells are there, and these cells, they are found in the lining in the resin ducts. Like they store resin and they are termed as secretory parenchyma. The parenchyma cells, they generally perform metabolic activities in the plant. They also provide rigidity and turgidity to the plant body. Now, like here I have shown that these parenchyma tissues, they help in the turgidity of the cells and they give a rigidity to the plant organs, and they also provide mechanical strength to the plants by maintaining a high osmotic pressures. After this, the next simple permanent tissue is collenchyma. In the Greek, the word colla, it means glue, and enchyma means an infusion. Collenchyma is a living tissue like a parenchyma, and the cells here, they are also thin walled. They actually have thin cells but are thickened only at the corners. There are no intercellular spaces, that means they are compactly, the cells of the collenchyma, they are compactly arranged. In the cross section, the cells may appear circular, oval or polygonal, and there might be elongated cells also. These are the elongated cells. Now, collenchyma cells, they are generally present below the epidermis in the dicot stems, but in the monocots and in the dicot roots, these cells are absent. They are present in the petiole and midrib of the dicot leaves. Now, the functions of the collenchyma. Collenchyma cells, they generally act as living mechanical tissue of young dicot stems. They are present in petioles and midribs of dicot leaves. Collenchyma is flexible, so it can resist bending and stretching caused by the winds. They also help in the growth of the plant organs in which they are present. Sometimes they contain chlorophyll and they also help in the photosynthesis. Collenchyma is also present at the margins of some leaves and they resist the tearing effect of wind. After this, the next type is sclerenchyma permanent tissue. In the Greek, the word scleres means hard and enchyma means an infusion. The main characteristic feature is that the cells of the sclerenchyma, they have thick cell walls, and sclerenchyma cells, they are generally dead cells. Now, if we see the structure of sclerenchyma, the cell wall thickening is mainly due to lignin deposition and it is uniformly deposited. Now, what is lignin? Lignin, it is a complex polymeric molecule which is composed of cellulose and phenylpropanoid units, and which helps or which provides the strength to the cell walls. That's why the cell walls of the sclerenchymatous cells, they become rigid and impermeable to water. So because of these depositions, the cell lumen becomes narrow. Now, if we see the functions, being thick walled, they give the mechanical support to the plant organs. It is chief mechanical tissue in the plants. It gives protection to the plant body from various adverse physical conditions. Now, based on the shape, sclerenchymatous tissues, they are of two types, that is fibers which are elongated and sclerids. If we talk about fibrous sclerenchymatous tissues, these are having the elongated cells with the tapering ends and they occur in bundles. Now, this type of fibrous sclerenchymatous tissue, they are generally present in jute and coir. Jute and coir, they are obtained from the thick bundles of the fibers. Now, coming to the sclerids, they are also called as stone cells. Sclerids are extremely thick walled cells. They are not elongated. They are varying in shapes. They may be a branchiscleroid or astrosclerid, which appears star shaped. This is also called as a branched sclerid. They have very narrow lumen. Sclerids, as I have told you, that they are also called as stone cells. They are brittle, that means they are not flexible, and so they cannot be spun into fibers. They may occur singly or in aggregates throughout the ground tissue. Now, where these sclerids are present? Children, you must have eaten pear. That crunchiness in the pear, it is because of the sclerids. We can say that it adds grittiness in the fruit pulp of these fruits due to presence of sclerids. Also, these are present in the shells of nuts and seed coats of legumes. So that's it for today. Thank you so much.